In this video, we'll look at Spotfire metadata as it relates to self-service analytics. Metadata means describing the data, essentially data about data. Typically, we're talking about the structure of the data, as well as other information such as where it was collected from, its purpose, and when it was collected, along with various other abstractions that are relevant to our model. Let's have a quick look at a couple of examples. Let's go to Edit, and we'll select Data Table Properties. And you can see here some metadata about our table. So if I click on Source Information, we'll see where this file came from. Likewise, if we go to Edit and Column Properties, we'll also see properties about these columns. So we'll see the column type, data type, its external name if it came from an external source, and so on. And then if we go to the formatting tab, we'll see how a specific column is formatted. As well, we can check some properties of an individual column. So this is all metadata. And here's the thing. Metadata provides end users and data administrators with a succinct and clear description of the data, and metadata, in fact, is considered by many to be an irreplaceable tool for the communication of the purpose of analytics. And this is especially important in the context of self-service. In fact, in the context of self-service analytics, metadata takes on an even deeper meaning as it can be used to essentially drive our analysis. It may be considered as a way to express business rules and user requirements that can be understood by designers, developers, administrators, and consumers of our analytics. Essentially, a global declaration of the purpose and meaning of our analytics and its constituent data components and rules. Let's consider configurable business rules. Business rules, at their core, are a type of metadata. They determine how the KPIs, the key performance indicators, metrics, and parameters are defined. Many times you'll find them hard-coded, but they can also be anticipated to some extent and can therefore be incorporated in our analytics in a way that we can drive these rules by incorporating user input. For developers and designers, the task is to make the platform as flexible as possible while maintaining a required level of administrative governance over the data as well as the platform and its infrastructure. One way that this is achieved is by including metadata tables in our analysis. Let's have a quick look at a metadata table. Now, this is a really, really simple example. So I've got a couple of columns here. I've got KPI, which is the name of the key performance indicator, and I've got an expression column. So this basically could be incorporated into my analysis as a way to help drive whatever key performance indicator that I am trying to allow my users to gain insight from. So in fact, what I would do is I would have several rows here, or at least more than one, and I would have a couple of different key performance indicators that the user could select in order to drive their own analysis. So what we've done here by including this metadata is we've incorporated a table in our analysis that describes all the information that we want to offer as a way to configure the analysis for the end user. As we move forward in this course, you'll see some much more detailed examples of this in the development of self-service analytics. So in this video, we discussed metadata in Spotfire as it relates to self-service analytics.